Welcome to the Escambia County Demonstration Garden. I'm Beth Bolles, a horticulture agent, and a lot of times during the winter months, we don't think about being as active in the landscape, but actually the cooler temperatures this time of year make it the perfect time to grow some of our winter vegetables. So just with a little preparation and care, a lot of homeowners can have a small space or even a lot of vegetables that they can use to supplement their meal or even share with family and friends. So we're gonna walk back to several of our beds and get you started on how to get your winter vegetables going. We traditionally think about growing the garden in the ground, but nowadays we often use raised beds or even containers for growing a lot of our vegetable crops. And that makes it a lot easier for homeowners who have limited space. Here at the Extension office, we use these raised beds, and the key point to remember, whether it's container or bed, is to make sure there's at least 12 inches for those roots to expand out. Some of our winter vegetables, like carrots and beets, have that root that's going to enlarge that we enjoy, and they need room so that they're not deformed as they grow. Now, for a raised bed or container, you can go to the nursery and purchase a really good quality garden soil like this one. It has a lot of composted material in it that holds moisture and then will slowly provide nutrients as well. Now, for a bigger bed, it gets a little more expensive. We often buy a mushroom compost and fill up that bed, or even today you can go for ECUA's new Bloom compost, and that's one that's a recycled material from our yard waste. Either way, get that material in, and for most of the time with compost, you're ready to plant immediately. So let's talk about what we can plant and how to install it. Now, there are several ways that you can start your winter vegetables. Some crops have to be started from seed, like carrots or some of your root crops like turnips and beets. Those are things that you really don't move after they're installed in the garden. So often you will buy a package from seed from a local nursery, and you often get more seed than you need. A lot of vegetable crops have very small seed, and so because they're so small, you really don't want to plant them deeply in the soil. So often what we'll do is we may make a little furrow in the garden like this, and then we will sprinkle those seeds in, often spacing them at the improper spacing because they're so small. Often with these, we have to come back after they're up and thin them out so that there's enough space in between them for something to develop. So you gently just pull that soil back over and pat down. And the key with seeding, always have a label close by, because you will never remember where you put those seeds. And even when they come up, you won't remember what they are. Another technique that we use, you can buy individual transplants from the nursery, like this mustard. And with this one, all you need to do is pull that out of the pot, lightly kind of tear that root ball to let those roots expand, and then you just dig your hole in the soil. It's very loose in this good compost, and make sure that it's planted where the soil is even with the surrounding, and fill that in. The key with these type vegetables like broccoli and mustard, we have a guide that tells you how far apart to space them, or your plant label may tell you. That's really important in the vegetable garden. When you first install your garden, it's going to look like you have lots of room, but these plants are going to grow at least 12 inches, and for a cabbage, it could be 24. So you don't want things too crowded, or that's just not going to do as well for your plant. The good thing about the winter garden with these, you don't have to do too much more after they're installed. A little water if we go through a dry spell. Sometimes we get a little fertilizer and side dress around them. But that's the enjoyable part about growing some of these winter crops, is it's a lot easier than some of our summer crops. So it's kind of a waiting game from this point, and then we're ready to harvest. Now, the reason we grow a vegetable garden is the harvest. And so you're planning for months down the road when these things are mature. You need to check them routinely because they do come on pretty quickly, and you don't want them to get too mature. For example, on our turnip here, these are starting to get, if we leave them too much longer, where that root would get a little bit bitter. So once you see the development, we have some information. If you're not an expert on harvesting yet, we can certainly help. But other crops like our broccoli is just starting to form that flower, and so we're checking that every day so that flower doesn't begin to open so that we can have the freshest broccoli possible. Some plants like broccoli, you harvest the flower and it will produce more. Other plants like cabbage, you harvest the whole plant once it's complete. But we're gonna get in here and cut our broccoli florette right down in here. With this broccoli florette, you cut just a little bit of the stem, and what's gonna happen, there are buds down in there that will form smaller florets that you will continue to harvest through the winter. Now, one thing to really remember about vegetable gardening, it's not just one planting. If we planted everything at the same time, we'd be harvesting everything all at once. We want to be successively planting so that we have things coming on for weeks and months, and we can harvest and have a continual group of vegetables for our plate and family and friends. So in addition to some of the winter vegetables, these cooler months are also really good for a lot of our herbs, like dill. We have lemon thyme, oregano, sage, rosemary. So these plants can also really enhance your garden, and a lot of these are perennial, so they will last even into the summer months. The good thing about both herbs and vegetables in the winter season is many of them are very tolerant of light frost and will even do well when we experience freezing temperatures. Maybe a little damage, but all of them are suited to this Florida climate. So if you need more information about growing some of these winter vegetables, please contact us at the Escambia County Extension or come visit us here at our demonstration gardens.